In a previous video, I've introduced Bolt.new, and it's great for creating new projects from scratch. But can it be used just as effectively when working with existing projects? Today, we're diving into how you can supercharge your existing projects using Bolt.new, StackBlitz, and Netlify. We will load an existing public GitHub repo to Bolt.new to make some changes, set up continuous deployment with Netlify with a custom domain, and make further changes using Bolt.new and StackBlitz. Let's get started. So what existing projects shall we use? Well, to make this video a complete guide, we will create a new project, upload it to GitHub, and set up continuous deployment. We will then use the existing project to make improvement using Bolt.new and StackBlitz. Let's start by creating a new project using Bolt.new. Let's head over to Bolt.new and sign in with a pre-account. I will authorize Bolt.new to use my GitHub account here. So once signed in, we'll see a prompt to create a new project. Let's type in this prompt that I have prepared in advance. The app will present a list of negative situations, feelings, etc. I ask it to create 10 items for now. And upon selection, the button labeled Flip It is enabled. And when clicked, it presents a positive thing, adding some humor to lift the mood of the user despite the selected unfavorable situation. I will use AI later, so don't forget to subscribe. But for now, use predefined responses. Use Svelte and Bootstrap. Bolt.new now generates the project almost instantly, so we'll just have to wait for a bit. You'll notice a preview window showing the generation of the code here. Now it's listing the situations and the positive responses for it. Now it's running the app by npm run dev. It automatically previewed the app, so we can see the list of situations here. We can try it. For example, my car broke down. Flip it. The positive flip. Time for an exciting bike adventure. Of course, this is a very simple app. We will use AI on a later video to improve this app. Now that we have our project, let's deploy it to Netlify. In Bolt.new, we can click on the deploy button. So let's try on using that. This action will initiate the deployment process using Netlify. Alright, so it successfully built the app and deployed it to Netlify. And we have a chance to view the app here on this URL. And if you want, we can claim the project on Netlify, which means will allow us to manage it directly on Netlify. We will not do that because we will deploy in Netlify later manually. So let's just preview it using the provided URL. So just like in the preview window of the Bolt.new, it works as expected here. Now that we have a Bolt.new project, what's next? We can leave this project as is, but real projects need continuous improvements. As you can see here, the UI is not really that great. Although we can use Bolt.new to ask for more changes, we need a more permanent solution to enable a more cohesive development workflow, collaboration, and continuous deployment. So how can we do that? First, we need to create a GitHub repository for our project. To do that without leaving our browser, we can open this Bolt.new project in StackBlitz. You can see here there's a open in StackBlitz button. Let's click on that. It will install the needed dependencies or packages and run it automatically, as we can see here. So it still works as before. We can also do some changes manually using this more powerful online IDE with enhanced features. So the IDE provided by Bolt.new is really just a basic IDE, but the one provided by StackBlitz has more features in it. To enable version control, we'll need a new GitHub repository. We can do that directly here in StackBlitz. You can see there's a button here, create a repository. Let's click on that. And we can see that GitHub app configuration is required. Since I haven't connected my StackBlitz account with my GitHub account, this is required. So let's do that. Let's click on configure app. We will be asked to install and authorize StackBlitz. Right now, all repositories is selected by default. We can change this later for our security. So for now, let's click on install and authorize. Now that we have authorized GitHub, we can close this and update the status. So now we can see that StackBlitz app is installed in GitHub. So let's click proceed. Looks like nothing's happening. Let's try that again. Let's click on create a repository again. Now we are asked to name our new repository. I will name this Mood Flip App. I will not check this button to make this repository public, so you can view it by yourselves later on. Let's now click create a repository. This is normal, so you can just click on leave. Now we are presented with a more advanced version of the IDE. You can see that source control option is now available here, and the extensions also is available. And GitHub integration is now successful. We are asked to install extensions. We can do that. We can also enable bot. And as you can see, as before, we can see the preview of the app here, and it's still working fine. With our GitHub repository ready, let's set up continuous deployment on Netlify. In order to do that, we can log into netlify.com. This is also free, so I can sign up with GitHub. Since I'm already signed in to my GitHub account, it will go straight to this authorize Netlify auth. So we can click authorize Netlify. Netlify will ask some questions. Let's continue to deploy. Now we will be asked to deploy our first project. Since this is the next step that we need to do, we can click on GitHub Repo. Let's authorize Netlify. And then here, we can select the new repository that we created earlier. So click on Only Select Repositories and click on this repository. And then click Install. Then we can click on the mood clip up here. So now we can deploy our project. But if we do this right now, it will not work because the publishing folder is set to public, and that's not the directory that we want. In order to find out which directory or publishing directory we can use in Netlify, we can go back to StackBlitz. We can run here npm run build, and it should create a new directory. Usually it's this. There you go. So this. So going back to Netlify, clicking this will not work. So we need to edit build settings. So this is correct. This is the GitHub branch to deploy. We can leave base directory as is. This is the correct build command. And in the publish directory, we need to change it to this. We can leave the rest as is. And then we can click on deploy mood-lib app to Netlify. So now the deployment is in progress. This text here is auto-generated. We can change this later if you want. So now it's initializing deploy success. So let's click on get started. So how can we preview the site? We can click on this first and then click on the deployed URL here. As we can see, we were able to deploy our repository to Netlify and our app still works. You might notice that the URL is not that memorable. This URL does not represent our ownership of the app. So what's the solution? We need to use a custom domain. To do that, let's go back to Netlify, click on domain management, and then click on add domain. Here we are asked to provide a custom domain or subdomain. We can buy a new domain in Netlify or buy it somewhere else like Namecheap or some other domain registrar. I already have a domain called aidrivencoder.com. So what I will do is I will create a new subdomain for this project. We need to configure our DNS settings depending on your domain provider. In my case, I'm using AWS Route 53. So let me go to AWS Route 53. I will use moodflip.aidrivencoder.com. Let's go back to Netlify. Let's click on verify. AIdrivencoder.com is already registered. So we can click on add subdomain. Let's click on awaiting external DNS, and then it says here that we need to create a new CNAME record. Copy the CNAME value and go to AWS Route 53. Make sure the record type is CNAME and paste in the value we copied earlier. Let's go back to Netlify and then let's try to refresh. So it's now checking the status and that message disappeared. That means we can open the app using the subdomain that we have created. Let's try that. As you can see, we were able to open the app using the subdomain we created. But notice that the site says it's not secure. That's because we don't have the SSL certificate yet. Let's go to AWS and search for Certificate Manager. There it is. Let's click on that. Let's request a certificate. Let's click on Next to request a public certificate. For the fully qualified domain name, let's type in our subdomain. Then let's leave the default options selected. It's now pending validation. So there's a domain section here. Let's create records in Route 53. It's still pending validation. Maybe it's still waiting for the propagation. So this is normal usually when we're dealing with DNS. Let's try to refresh and the status is still the same, pending validation. Now the status is issued. So let's see if we can refresh and have a secure site. There you go. We have successfully deployed the app using a custom subdomain in Netlify. So now let's focus on updating or making changes to our project. If we take a look at our project, we have a lot of room for improvement. But let's make a simple change using StackBlitz. Let's change the title to something else. So in order to do that, we can go to index.html and let's change this and then save. Of course, this will not change automatically because we need to push our changes to GitHub first. To do that, let's go to source control. Let's click on stage all changes and then let's add a message for our commit. Let's just simply say update page title. Then click on commit and push. Now our change has been committed and pushed to GitHub. Netlify will automatically detect that change and deploy this app automatically. So now if we go to deploys, we can see that the update page title commit causes a new deployment. We can click on this to see the details as before. So now it's complete. We can now go to our app and refresh. And as you can see, the title has been updated. Suppose you want to make further changes using AI. Right now, StackBlitz doesn't have that ability. But we can use Bolt.new to make further changes. But the problem is, the project in the Bolt.new is now outdated. If you go to index.html, even if we click reload, the title still is outdated. Though this change is simple, you can imagine larger changes that could make your original Bolt.new project outdated. So how can we load our updated project back to Bolt.new? We can just simply prefix the URL with bolt.new/github.com, your GitHub username, and the name of your repository. Let's click on enter. So now bolt.new will load the code we have in our repository. We can now close this old bolt.new window. And we can see in the index.html that it now reflects the latest title that we have changed earlier. So now let's use bolt.new to make further changes. So let's say improve the UI and add some animations. Bolt.new will process our request and update the project accordingly. It's still making some changes on mood.blip. We can go to code to see what's changed and go back to preview to see the improvement it did. And we can see that there's a hover effect now. And if we click, we can flip it and there's a animation there. However, since bolt.new isn't connected to our GitHub repository for commits, these changes will not automatically reflect our deployed app. So even if we refresh this, the UI still is the same as before. So what can we do? We'll need to transfer these changes manually. So let's go back to bolt.new and find out which files has been updated. So we know that this has been updated. We can click on it, we can copy it, and go back to our StackBlitz window, find where that component or that file is. Let's check if that's built, and then paste over the changes. Save. Let's also do the same for this file, mood.blip.svelte. Copy everything, go back to the StackBlitz window, and then paste the changes. Then we can refresh or reload the preview window. And we can see that the changes has been reflected to our code here in StackBlitz. But we cannot see that animation properly. Let's try to deploy this. Click commit and push. Let's go to Netlify, go to deploys, and we can see it's starting up for the improve UI and add animations. So it's important to have a more descriptive commit messages. So now it's published. Let's go to our app and refresh. And the changes has been reflected, but we cannot see the animation properly right now. Let's fix that. Since it's a simple fix, let's go to StackBlitz. Let's go to mood.blip. There you go. Now let's see. There. But that's too much. Let's reduce this to, say, 200 pixels. There. Then let's commit the change. Let's go back to Netlify and see that the latest commit is being deployed. So now it's deployed. We can go back to our app and refresh, and we can see that it added some margin below. And then we can properly see the animation. Let's recap the steps we took. We created a new project in Bolt.new, opened the project in StackBlitz, and created a new GitHub repository. We set up a continuous deployment in Netlify. We set up a custom domain in Netlify, set up an SSL using AWS Certificate Manager. We made changes to StackBlitz and pushed those changes in GitHub, which triggers the deployment in Netlify. We made further changes using Bolt.new, but we have to manually copy the changes back to StackBlitz in order to deploy those changes. While this workflow is powerful, it does have some pain points. First, manual transfer of changes. Since Bolt.new isn't directly connected to GitHub, we cannot commit our changes. So we have to manually copy the changes back to StackBlitz. It also lacks fine-grained version control. Any changes that we make here will not be stored or the history will be lost. There's no fine-grained version control. Although, I think we can roll back to a specific checkpoint, we also have a chat history limitation right now. If we reload this page, the chat where we said improve the UI and add some animation is now gone. But StackBlitz mentioned that they will deploy changes to retain the chat history soon. Probably by the time you watch this video, it's already out. So what's the alternative solution? In our next video, there's a nice alternative to this, but the downside is we will not be using Bolt.new anymore, or exclusively at least. By using StackBlitz and a Visual Studio extension called Cline, we will be able to seamlessly make changes within our IDE without leaving or switching back and forth between StackBlitz and Bolt.new. So don't forget to subscribe and watch out for that upcoming video with a step-by-step guide on how to set up Cline, which is previously Cloud Dev. Thanks for watching and happy coding!